You just blew it. It was probably wish you wouldn't have gotten any by Robert.
You wish for a wife, Robert? Don't, you lucky son of a gun now, hang in there.
Say exactly as you are. You may be the one constant in this world you bear your boys.
I don't know, Sarah. You can't stay in your 30s forever.
Oh, you still get your wish, Bobby.
Won't. I think he still gets his wish.
I say he won't.
When, huh? See, when she and Robert get together.
Larry, I'm telling you, if you do not blow out all the candles on the cake, you do not get your wish. I know all the rules to birthday candle blowing out. I've had enough for a wax museum.
All right, all right. Actually, I didn't wish for any.
What do you mean you didn't wish for?
Oh, tell. Everybody's so curious.
Tell, but why?
Thank you for including me in your thoughts, your lives.
Stay exactly as you are, Robert.
That's right, you sweet thing. Stay exactly as you are.
Everyone adores you. What an awful thing. Everything happens for the best. I don't even believe it myself.
I mean, when you've got friends like mine. Isn't it warm? Isn't it rosy? Side by side.
He's such a cutie.
By side.
Isn't he a cutie?
Ports in a storm. Comfy and cozy. Side by side.
In that room, he's cool.
By side.
I am glad.
Everything shines. How sweet. Side by side.
I'm just so fond of him.
Without you.
Hey!
Ah, marriage is squabble, available wobble, be there with the glue. Who can we open up to? Secrets to keep from guess who? Who is so safe and who is so sound? You never need an analyst to bobby around. How will we ever get through? What would we do without you?
Why? Did you hear I didn't?
No, but look, this is just precious. precious.
It is, isn't it? I never really look at it, I just live here.
It's terribly clever. See how nicely all the furniture is placed in areas to make it so warm and sweet and tucked in?
How about that?
And the choice of colors is so relaxing and simple and masculine.
See that?
Isn't that tasteful and interesting?
Yes, I'll take it. I mean, I've always liked my apartment. I'm just never really in it. I just seem to pass through the living room on my way to the bedroom to go to the bathroom to get ready to go out again.
You never really spend any time in here? And it's so dear. But maybe that's why you like it so much. If you don't spend much time in it, it keeps it special and important.
Yes. And this, over here, is the bedroom. You love it, I can tell. Well, I can always look for another place. You don't mind my telling this, do you?
No.
It just came to my mind.
I
Anyway, we just connected in such a beautiful way, exactly like tonight. Except we couldn't even contain ourselves. It was incredible. We were talking when suddenly we realized we just couldn't talk anymore. No sounds came. We stood looking at each other, we were both bathed in perspiration. Our breathing was so short and our legs were trembling, and we just left. We drove out to one of those strips there where they have all those motels, and we didn't even say anything. She just sat so close to me. So close. We got inside that room and we started touching and kissing and laughing and holding. And suddenly she realized I should go and get lots of champagne and some baby oil, and we should get beautifully high and then rub. Well, you know, she said she'd be in bed waiting. So I rushed out of there and drove around until I could find a liquor store and a drugstore open, and I got all the champagne and the oil, and I finally started back to the motel, and I could not find it. I looked for over 3 hours. I never found it, and I never saw her again.
Oh, that is the most extraordinary story I have ever heard. That poor, poor girl. And you drove around for 3 hours.
More. All night I spent trying to find that motel. I mean, all night. With the oil and all that champagne and my hands trembling and sweat running down my face.
Oh, that girl. She never knew. Oh, wow. I just don't know what to say or do. That is so sad.
I know. It is. Very. Yes, that's it.
I like that.
love you, Harry.
I love you, Sarah.
I love you, David.
I love you, Jenny.
I love you. I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
To get the divorce?
Divorce? You're not married now.
Well, not since the divorce.
Oh,
I flew down to Mexico. It is absolutely sensational down there. It is so terrific that I phoned Susan to come down and join me.
It's just so pretty down there.
Where are you living now, Peter?
Well, here at home. I mean, I've got responsibilities. Susan and the kids to take care of. I certainly wouldn't leave them.
Well, it sure seems to be working.
Oh, goodness, look at this. We're all four single. It's nicer, I think, especially when you have somebody. Now, this is what I call New York.
Here's to the ladies who watch every
I would like a cigarette, Larry. Remember when everyone used to smoke? How he was a more festive, happier or something. Now every place is not unlike an operating room. For Christ's sake, huh?
I never smoked.
Why?
I don't know. I meant to. Does that count?
Meant to? Meant to? Story of your life, meant to? Jesus, you were lifted right out of a craft Evan case history. You were always outside looking in the window while everyone was inside dancing at the party. Now, I insist you smoke. Your first compromise. Here, Rob, smoke.
No, thank you.
Joanne, come on. He doesn't.
You smoke, I'll watch.
Watch? Did you hear yourself? Did you hear what you just said? You don't watch. I am offering you—
I don't want to.
Because you're weak. I hate people who are weak. That's the best. Better than Prozac. Smoking may be the only thing that separates us from the lower forms.
You want to split?
Of what?
You see, Robert, every day, Joanne here tests me. Twice a year, my wife packs up to leave, so I'll ask her to stay. Now, my mother was a very difficult woman, and my old man left her, and he regretted it until the day he died. Now me, hey, I married this wildly conceited broad with no self-esteem. I got me a wife who still has this hard time believing that she found a guy that she daily fascinates. And, unlike my father, I'm a very happy man. Just act like this when you're not around, Bobby. I hope you get to meet Joanne sometime. She's really a terrific lady. In fact, if you ever decide to get married, Bobby, make sure you find someone just like her.
Don't ever get married, Bobby. Why should
you? Oh, I don't know. For company? Like everybody else.
Who else?
Like everyone who's ever fallen in love and gotten married.
I know both couples, and they're both divorced. Oh, Larry, you interrupted me earlier. I wanted to toast my second husband. See what happens when you rush me?
I'm going to the job. And when I come back, we'll be leaving. This holiday is over.
I got the check. Dang, I know he's off to pay the check. Or maybe buy the place. It is a comfort to have rich friends, but I do like to pay some of the time. Oh well, you talked me into it. You have a good third husband, Joanne. He's a good man. Anyway, thank you for the evening. I was really feeling low, really depressed. I drank, but you put it away today. The last several times you and I have gotten together, I've had shameful hangovers. Abominable. We may be doing permanent damage. Think of that. I don't know what to think of the fact you only drink with me. I guess that's not unflattering. No, I hope I don't depress you. We have good times and it's a hoot, yeah? Whatever you say. No, I would not like a cigarette if that's what you're trying to stare me into. I'm a product of my generation and I do not smoke. My age group is a very uptight age group. Middle age is pretty low, that would gain. It is very drunk out tonight. What are you looking at, Joanne? It's my charisma, huh? Well, stop looking at my charisma.
When are we going to meet?
I beg your pardon?
When are we going to make it?
What's wrong with now?
There's my place. It's free tomorrow after 2. Larry goes to the gym and then straight to the office. Don't talk. Don't do your folksy hair or tea with me. You're a terribly attractive young man. The kind of man most women seem to want but never get. I'll take care of you.
But who will I take care of?
Did you hear what you just said? Did you hear what you just said, kid?
I didn't mean—
Oh, I just hear a door open that's been stuck a long time.
Like I haven't looked at all that, at marriages and all that? And what do you get for it? What do you get?
What's wrong?
I've looked at all that, at marriages and all that. What do you get for it? What do you get?
What happened?
I just did someone a big favor. Come on, Larry. Let's just go home.
What do you get?
Thank you.
It must have been the apartment across the hall.
Do you think something's wrong?
No, I think something's right.
So do I.
Well, you called every joint in town.
It's been 2 hours. Maybe you can drive. How can anyone forget a surprise birthday party?
Or maybe the surprise is on us? I think I got the message. Come on, Larry. Let's go home.
Yeah, I think you should.
Yeah, I think we should go.
Maybe we should leave him a note.
Maybe we should leave him alone.
I'll call him tomorrow.
Don't.
I won't. David.
What?
Nothing. Okay. All together, everybody.